just learned that he recently moved into that apartment building, which is now booby trapped. We have a look at that apartment. The cops, the firefighters, the bomb squad now trying to figure out exactly what this sophisticated device actually is. Is it flammable? Is it explosive? They don't know. Meantime, they've got the entire building evacuated, and it could be evacuated for hours, even days, police said. We have also learned that James Holmes recently moved to Colorado to attend the University of Colorado Medical School, where he is studying to get his PhD in neuroscience, and we believe that he is also a biology student at a university here in Southern California, which makes one wonder if there's any kind of experience he might have with chemicals or explosives that we can tie in there. We have also learned that he does not have a hunting license. He does not have a concealed weapons permit, and yet police found him in the parking lot with four weapons, a semi-automatic rifle, a shotgun, two handguns, and inside his apartment they say they found buckets and buckets of ammunition. He has no ties to the military, he is not on any terror watch list, and as we've seen all morning long, his parents live in San Diego. His father is now in New Colorado. San Diego police say his mother is still inside the home in San Diego, and the family has now just issued a statement I want to read, saying, quoting here, "Our hearts go out to those who were involved in this tragedy and to the families and friends of those involved. We ask that the media respect our privacy during this difficult time. Our family is cooperating with authorities in both San Diego, California, and Aurora, Colorado. We are still trying to process this information, and we appreciate that people will respect our privacy." Now, we are told the parents may be cooperating. The suspect is no longer cooperating. That's what police say. Though the suspect did tell police that there were bombs or explosives at his apartment, that turned out to be the case.